Hello and welcome to Affinity. We've got another old photo here from subscriber Bob. Thanks, Bob. And we're going to look at the problems here. We've got a lot of light coming in here. We've got lines across here, probably from it being faded with something on top of it. Maybe, I don't know. So we're going to create a mask, which is going to try and copy the mask we got there already. So we'll just add a pixel layer. We'll pick a color. So an orange color, that's fine. And we're going to go to the paintbrush. Opacity, maybe about 20%. We can always play with that. And a very soft brush. And we're going to paint over here. And we're going to try to cover up the area that's going to be affected, the bit where we got some too much white. And we're going to go using left and right square bracket to paint in the areas we need a bit more. And do those fade lines there. And down a bit down there. And because we get some leakage and we want to go backwards, when we want to do that, we're going to go to the erase brush. Because the erase brush, we can just with that there, lowish opacity, bit harder, because we're going to draw along the lines here and erase the orange underneath that line. Similarly up here, and then what we can do is turn this on and off, on off, on off, and look for where there's a difference, where we can add more or erase more. I'm going to take that one down a bit there, and likewise this one. It's got a taper on it. And we can do this for a while, but that's the effect we want. So what we're going to do is go to, now we're going to put in, first of all, turn this into a mask. So layer rasterized to mask. Looks a bit funny, don't worry about it. Because we're going to put an adjustment up here of curves. And for this, we're going to drag the curves to the top. There we go, then the mask up. So it's a little vertical blue bar. And now we can darken that picture because the mask on it is only going to affect the areas we selected. See where that's happening now? That's just fading. Even though we pull this down quite a long way, we're darkening those areas there. It's not fully done, so what we can do is do another mask on top. So I do another curves on top. Do this one slightly differently. Drag this up so we can see it. There we go. Now we can just kind of pull this down, and we're just going to look at the areas which need to go a bit darker still. And so we'll pull those down. Then we'll click on the curves here, Control I to invert it. And we then want a paintbrush, which is going to be white, to paint on top of the mask, yes, which is in the curves adjustment, to bring back the curves. So you can see as I paint on this, I'm getting a bit more out here. Yes, I'm getting that extra darkening coming going on. I could have started off with this, but it's quicker often and even better to try and recreate the areas you want to affect in a mask. So that's taking it a bit further. So you're doing kind of incrementally. Then going to put in an extra layer again, pixel layer on top. And with that, I'm going to do a little bit of cloning to get rid of these horizontal lines. So I'm going to go to the clone tool here, and importantly here, get current layer and below up there. So I'm going to go, what's the brush like here? Medium, that's okay. Yeah, lowish, so we can have the multiple things. So we're going to alt click below here and then paint on top. See where that just gets rid of this. Normally I go in close and be very careful with this. And let's do these. So alt click and down here. Keep careful to get those folds okay. I'm doing it so a little bit of variation makes it harder to see any fixed edges, so we're going to make that a bit darker there. And might I'll actually take a little bit up here and paint a bit down here to darken that a bit. That'll do, and now let's... So, I won't finish that off because I just go in and spend ages doing the detail. But you can already see there's a lot more that we've done. So, next thing we're going to do, let's add a quick bit of sharpening. That can often help. So, radius up a bit here and the factor up steadily. That is a bit more coming out of that. And we'll put on top of that another layer of curves. So, curves up there. And this is to add contrast, so I'll just do an S curve. And that's made that a bit more. And if you want to readdress any of this, we can always go down to those extra layers. So, if I'm going to do this. Shift click there to select all of that. There we go. So I can turn those off. There's the original and there's the change. Within that's about 6 minutes. No one would expect to spend half an hour or more doing something like that, but you get the idea. Anyway, that's it, and thank you very much for watching.